الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. We're at the point in the seerah of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when things are, as you can tell, they're increasingly getting more and more difficult. There have been these two trips, these two migrations from Mecca to Abyssinia to East Africa to Al-Habasha, and even within, so for those who remain behind in Mecca, the persecution is increasing and it continues to deepen and get worse and worse. But as Allah reminds us in the Quran, with hardship there is ease, as well as after hardship there is ease. So there's this hardship occurring, but then Allah sends not only some relief but a lot of relief. Within that window of time, it immediately offered relief, but then even, you know, over time, it would have even larger and more significant implications that we benefit from even until now. And this is when Sayyidina Hamzah radiallahu anhu, the paternal uncle, one of the paternal uncles of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he embraces Islam. And it's interesting, the background of that. One day Abu Jahl gave the Prophet ﷺ an even harder time and spoke to him even harsher than usual. And then the Prophet walks away, and you know that situation concludes. And then Hamzah, he comes back, وَرَزُقُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. Allah provides from places you would never expect. He happens to be coming back from hunting, and there was a lady who witnessed the whole thing and tells him, do you know what just happened to your nephew? And so he and the Prophet, they were within a year of each other. They were basically the same age, and they grew up very, very, very close as it was. And you can tell between the you know how they say opposites attract sometimes. The Prophet was the very kind and gentle one, and then Hamza was the tough guy to kind of to balance things out within that specific dynamic. So Hamza, he's coming back, and this lady tells him that, do you know what just happened to your nephew? He says, no, what? And she tells him, this is what I witnessed, this is what I saw, this is what I heard. And this got him, and he asked, what did my nephew do? She said, nothing, he just walked away. That made him even more upset. On top of that, you know, that was how things concluded. So he felt an even stronger sense of wanting to defend him. So he goes to Abu Jahl, who's in front of the Kaaba with some of his friends, and basically Hamza, he smacks him, and he tells him, like, I'm with this deen too now. You know, what are you going to do? And Abu Jahl told his friends, like, you know, leave him, like, he's right, I did go too far, basically. So Hamza accepts Islam. This was a major factor. And then within a few days, within a week, basically, you have Sayyidina Umar accepting Islam as well, subhanAllah. And as soon as Abdullah bin Mas'ud, he said, as soon as they accepted Islam, specifically when Umar accepted Islam, then, you know, then we had this, you know, we had a lot more strength. Then we started praying in front of the Kaaba publicly with, you know, without concern, basically. So these two people really swung things in favor of the Muslims. And I want to keep it short. What are some of the implications, lessons, and gems that we can take from it within our lives? When things are getting difficult, these stories remind us that the difficulty is there, but Allah can provide the ease. And Allah can provide the ease significantly from places that we would not expect. And the implications that I was referring to that we continue to benefit from until now, look at what ended up happening during the time of Sayyidina Umar, during his caliphate, when he's Khalifa. Look at the impact that he had on Islam and the Muslims, and look at his role in human history. Michael Hart, his top 100 most influential people of all time, it includes Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala. Right? So there's the hardship, and it feels permanent. But then Allah sends relief that ends up outweighing the pain, and then doors open after doors after doors after doors. The difficult part, we know it's easier said than done, the difficult part is hanging on, even when things are difficult, hoping for that ease. And we ask Allah to send all of us ease. All of us have different challenges, different, you know, difficulties in our lives. Hopefully that ease is right around the corner. Hopefully that ease is, you know, we're on the cusp of it. We've all seen the picture where you have the two guys, you know, digging tunnels or something, and one of them walks away, and then the other one, you know, the gem is right there, it's right on the other side of it. So that reminds us, you know, of the value of patience. Maybe that blessing is right around the corner. We ask Allah to send all of us ease. We ask Allah to turn all of our difficulties and hardships into ease. We ask Allah to open doors from places that we would expect, and even from places that we would not expect. وَرَزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. We ask Allah to accept our efforts and forgive our mistakes. أَمِنْ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.